Hi, my name is Bob Litchfield. I'm an old bankruptcy lawyer in Auburn, California, and I want to talk to you for a minute about bankruptcy or financial crisis and your children. Now look, I know you got your hands full with all your other problems, your business challenges, your financial problems. Maybe you lost your job, you're worrying about if you're going to lose your house, how you're going to pay the mortgage or the bills. In the middle of all of that, sometimes you have a tendency to get so wrapped up in all of your own personal problems and the financial challenges of the family that you have a tendency to allow your children to become invisible. You just sort of forget about them, you put them off, you know, I've got more important problems I got to worry about. Listen to me, there is no more important problem than your child growing up with a good sense of self-esteem. There is no more important challenge in your life than acknowledging your child as an important human being, an important contributing member of your family. So please, no matter how difficult your financial problems may become, do not allow your children to become invisible. And you may ask yourself, well, what should I tell them about this possible bankruptcy, this financial crisis we're having, the job loss, or the possibility that we might even lose our homes? What should I tell them? And some of you are going to pretend that they don't exist so that you don't have to decide whether or not you're going to tell them anything. You've always been their hero in the past. If you tell them this, will you not be their hero anymore? Maybe you don't want to tell them. But if it's getting in between you and your relationship with your child, then tell them. They're human beings. They're remarkably strong and resilient human beings. They can adapt, they can adjust better than adults can. Trust me, I know. And I'll tell you why in a minute. But kids can handle it. If you feel like you need to tell them because you've been hiding it from them, clear the air, tell them. When you do tell them, try to be a little relaxed about it, because they're going to take your cue from you as to how serious and stressful and dramatic this financial problem is. And after all, you and I both know in reality, whatever the financial problem is, eventually it too will pass, and it's not nearly as serious as you're making it at night when you lay awake at night worrying about it. Okay, the other thing is, don't worry about your child losing respect for you. If it's a little child under 10, you have always been their hero. You always will be their hero. They don't care how much money you have in the bank. They really don't care whether you make the mortgage payment or not. They don't understand that stuff. All they know is, Dad's always been my hero and he's still my hero. Mom the same. To them, your wealth is not money and the ability to pay bills. To them, your true wealth is your time and your attention. All they know is, your son or your daughter, all they may know is, this is the only year that I get to be 6 years old. And you blink and that year will be over. This is the only year they get to be 6 years old, and maybe tonight when Dad gets home from work, he'll spend some time, he'll actually look at me and speak to me by my name and spend some time talking to me. Or maybe if I'm really lucky, he'll take me out in the yard and play tag with me or play ball with me for a while, and I'll get some of his greatest wealth, which is Dad's time and Dad's attention. You still have that to give. Doesn't matter how much money you have in the bank, that's what's most important to your young child. And as far as your teenager goes, if you think you're going to be a hero to your 15-year-old, let's not even go there. That just ain't happening, okay? And does it matter really? Is your 15-year-old going to push your buttons and test the limits of everything, whether you have money in the bank or you don't have money in the bank? Doesn't matter. So let's move on then, because there's a couple of other things I want to tell you about being with your children during a financial crisis, or any other time really. Some of you I know are going to be worrying about the possibility that you may lose your home, and maybe the only home the kids have ever known, and what kind of a crisis will it be, or what kind of an effect will it have on the kids if they have to move? If they have to move out of the home, maybe out of the neighborhood to find a new job, maybe even to a whole different city. Very stressful for you. could be very stressful for them too if they take their cues from you. But as a general rule, kids are remarkably resilient with regard to things like moving. If mom and dad are okay about it, they're going to be okay about it too. And kids are incredibly adjustable and flexible and adaptive and resilient. I know, I was a military kid. We had to move every 2 or 3 years the whole time I was growing up. And we came out fine, and I know lots of adults who are former military kids, including my own wife. We adapted, we adjusted, we made new friends wherever we went. We adjusted to the new house. We redecorated the new bedrooms and the new house, and life went on, and it was fine, and we had a lot of fun. We played, we made new friends. So don't worry about the kids having to move. If they have to move, they have to move, and they'll adjust. That's what kids do. They do it even better than adults.